It's 97.1 Amp Radio. It's McCabe in the SoCal Honda Sound Stage, and today joined by Arlissa. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you for stopping by. I want to say it started off great for you because downstairs in our lobby, we have like this claw machine.
Yeah.
And you won a shirt on your first try.
Ever. And I never win anything. So
that's a good way to start an interview. Woo! So you've been in LA for a few days.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, it's been kind of rainy. But have you had a chance to do anything? Like when you come to LA, do you have spots that you like to check out?
I do have a favorite restaurant that I have to go to every time.
Okay.
It's called Gracias Madre. Do you know it?
I don't know it.
It's so good. You have to
go. What side of town?
I don't really know that many sides of town.
Okay, all right. I know I'm asking you
Is it West Hollywood?
Yeah, probably West Hollywood. I see our camera guy over there, Carlos, shaking his head. That's like near him, so yes.
It's really great. It's great. It's vegan Mexican food.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
I'm delving more into the vegan, so that will definitely be a place that I check out.
Gotta give it a go.
Yeah.
You have to. I'm not vegan, but...
You're not vegan.
No,
I'm not either, but it's still... Yeah.
Not eating meat sometimes.
Okay, that's good. And I'm assuming you stayed inside most of the time since it's been raining.
Yeah, I feel like I brought the rain with me. What's going on?
I don't know. I mean, it rains a lot in London.
Yeah.
So you're bringing it over to the West Coast. Come on, man. I want some sunshine.
It's all my fault.
do you visit LA often? Like, do you come here just to work?
Yeah, no, I was here a couple of weeks ago, actually. Mm-hmm. I had a showcase here. It was my first ever show in LA.
Okay.
So that was amazing. Like, the people who came were incredible. They were singing my songs.
How is that? I mean, having your first show in LA, I mean, what's your reaction to that and seeing your fans sing your songs?
It was just like a totally indescribable feeling. I can't go any further than that, just because it feels so amazing. There's a lot that goes on. I've done it before. I was signed once before and it didn't work out. It didn't work out at all. I had no control, no freedom. I went from writing my own songs to just being told what to do all the time. Mm-hmm. And it really sucked for a good 4 years. 4 years of being told, no, that's not who you are.
Right.
And, it took a while to get out of that. But when I did, which was, a year and a half ago, I started putting out my music on Facebook. Uh-huh. And from then on, it kind of exploded. You know, Heart Sing on a Lie, which is a song that I have out now. Mm-hmm. I posted that, last November. Mm-hmm. And that went crazy viral. It got... more than 2 million views in less than a week.
Oh,
just watching it just go crazy, crazy, crazy. And then Jonas Blue found it,
mm-hmm.
contacted me through Facebook. And then we made a version together. And now I'm here sitting to you, McCabe.
Yes, congratulations on all the success with everything.
Thank you.
What can you tell us about Hearts Ain't Gonna Lie?
You know, I think I wrote it now a couple of years ago.
Mm-hmm.
I was in a darker space then. I kind of got used to not listening to my gut a lot. You should always listen to your gut, mm-hmm. always. And I don't like to delve too much into the situation that I was in just because it's not fun. But, it took me a while to kind of realize that I wasn't happy and to kind of trust my own instincts. And then I wrote this song and it definitely helped me get away from that. You know when you kind of push something to the back of your head and pretend that it's not there?
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I was doing that a lot. And then basically when I wrote this, I realized that's what I was doing,
mm-hmm.
and I stopped doing it. And luckily, I got a song out of it and I got to be happier.
And it's like a good therapy session to be able to do that for yourself,
mm-hmm.
And help other people, through your music. Now you're performing it. And how's that feeling? And
it's crazy.
Seeing people, respond to it.
Yeah, it's crazy. I mean, I get these amazing messages every day that I love reading, and people telling me how much the song means to them and how it's helped them. And that's the best feeling ever, because I never actually realized, I listen to music and it helps me so much, but I kind of never thought that my own music could help.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the strangest and most rewarding feeling, to know that you're helping in a small way.
It's a big way. what can we expect from 2018? You're out, you're touring right now, doing interviews and kind of spreading the music, but is there an album?
There'll definitely be an album.
Uh-huh.
100%.
And what do you want to, is this going to be a personal album? What do you want to do it?
Yeah, of course. Everything that I write, I put so much of myself into. These are my stories. I call them like life songs. They're not love songs, they're life songs, because they are what I experience in everyday life and how I feel. And you know, I put that out there, and I want people to listen to that and take from it what they will. And but yeah, it will be a personal album, 100%.
And you don't have just a set time? Is it spring, summer, or are you just like, I don't know yet, I'm dropping music when I want to drop music?
I'm dropping music when I want to.
There we go. I like that. And we're gonna have tours, performances. Are you gonna set some?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I'm.
Are you gonna come back to LA and do another gig?
Yeah, I'm touring a bit in the UK. So if anyone is around going to the UK in April, hop on over, come back.
Right there.
And then I'm definitely coming back and doing some shows in the US. So people just need to follow my socials, and then I'll let you guys know.
We'll stay on it. And I know. Okay, you're making music, you're doing music, but when you're in Los Angeles and it's not raining, what are some things? What's like a to-do list that you want to check out next time you're here, so we can make that happen?
Yes, I really like hiking. You guys are so lucky. You can just like go to work, go on a hike, and every day, like, I can't do that. Where's my mountain to climb?
I'm not gonna lie, like literally 30 minutes before the interview, there's this place called Runyon Canyon.
Yeah.
So I was like up there, and I'm like,
exactly.
Oh, this is great. And then I'm gonna go talk to Arlissa. It's just this, I love this.
Yeah.
So yes, more hiking.
Yeah,
okay.
More hiking, 100%. More, I don't know. What? Give me something. Like, what should I do?
I mean, there's so much to do. Enjoy the food, the beach, go to Santa Monica, Venice, yeah. Malibu. I think you're gonna find your way, and you're gonna have a good time doing it.
I feel
just
the same.
Don't bring the rain next
the
time,
same.
Please.
I will do my very best.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Anytime, Arlissa, you want to stop by 97.1 Amp Radio, please do.
I will hold you to that.
And we love the new music, and we look forward to new music and the album and the tour. And thank you so much.
Thank you.
Arlissa,
thank you so much.
With 97.1 Amp Radio.